Conformal field theories are quantum field theories that are invariant under so-called conformal transformations. In this video, we will investigate these conformal transformations in three or more dimensions. For infinitesimal conformal transformations, we have the condition that d mu epsilon nu plus d nu epsilon mu has to be equal to 2 over d times the divergence of epsilon times the metric. Here it's not yet specified in how many dimensions we work, so it's just d. Before we continue, it's useful to derive one more equation for epsilon. First, we take the divergence with respect to d nu. This yields d mu acting on the divergence of epsilon plus d mu epsilon, which we can write as the box operator. On the right-hand side, we get d mu acting on the divergence of epsilon after contracting the derivative with the metric. Now we take one more derivative with respect to d nu. This yields d mu d nu acting on the divergence of epsilon plus the box operator acting on d nu epsilon mu, and this is equal to 2 over d times d mu d nu acting on the divergence of epsilon. This equation has a tensorial shape like a 2 tensor. In the following, we will only consider the symmetric part of this tensor structure. Equivalently, one could exchange mu and nu and then add the two equations. But back to the symmetric part. The first term is symmetric in mu and nu since the derivatives can be exchanged. Also the right-hand side term is symmetric. For the remaining term, we have to write down the symmetric part, which is given by 1 half times d nu epsilon mu plus d mu epsilon nu. Using our first equation for epsilon, we can replace the symmetrized terms with 2 over d times the divergence of epsilon times eta mu nu. Let's also multiply the whole equation with d so that we can get rid of the fraction. We now have several operators acting on the divergence of epsilon, so let's put them all together. First, we have the box operator with eta mu nu, then d times d mu d nu, and then minus 2 times d mu d nu from the other side of the equation. Let us contract this with the metric, which yields d times the box operator plus d times the box operator minus 2 times the box operator. Altogether, acting on the divergence of epsilon equals 0. Dividing by 2 gives us an interesting equation. D minus 1 times the box operator acting on the divergence of epsilon is 0. In this video, we will focus on D greater than or equal to 3 dimensions. Our new equation tells us that in this case, the divergence of epsilon is linear in x. The box operator acts like a second derivative, and the second derivative of a linear function is 0. And if the divergence of epsilon is linear, then epsilon itself is quadratic in x. So we can write epsilon mu as a mu plus b mu nu x nu plus c mu nu rho x nu x rho. Remember that this is still an infinitesimal quantity, so a, b, and c are infinitesimally small as well. Since the conditions for conformal transformations have to be independent of x, we can study each of those three terms separately. The first constant, a, is not constrained at all, since we always talk about the derivative of epsilon. If we only have a, then this is just a space-time translation, because x plus epsilon yields just x plus a. To study the second term, we set a and c to 0 and plug the resulting epsilon into our initial condition for conformal transformations. This gives us the equation b mu nu plus b nu mu is equal to 2 over d times the trace of b times the metric. If we separate b into a symmetric and an antisymmetric part, we can extract a bit more information. Let us only consider the symmetric part. We get 2 alpha mu nu is equal to 2 over d times the trace of alpha times the metric. This tells us that alpha is in fact proportional to the Minkowski metric, and we can write it as a number alpha times eta. Now if we only consider the symmetric term, then x plus epsilon is a scale transformation. X gets multiplied with a factor 1 plus alpha. And the antisymmetric part corresponds to the usual Lorentz transformations. Finally, transformations using only the last term are called special conformal transformations. They are given by x plus c times x times x. And one can show that this is equivalent to x mu plus 2 over d c nu nu rho x rho minus 1 over d c nu nu mu times x squared. In summary, we found an interesting equation for epsilon and have now successfully identified the infinitesimal conformal transformations for three or more dimensions. And that's pretty much it for this time. Thanks for watching.